In this office hour, we want to talk about two important properties of the stochastic discount factor. Now, the first thing is we want to see that the conditional expected change in the SDF coincides with the risk-free rate. And second, that very important concept, we want to show that an asset that pays a risk premium pays only the risk premium for that part of risk within the asset that co-moves with the systematic sources of risk, which are nothing else than the shocks to the SDF. Okay, so let's do that. I will rely on the previous office hour on the SDF and some simple SDE calculus. So now we want to talk about these properties. So keep in mind, what's the SDF in a in an economy with only Brownian risk? We are saying that dm over m, or minus dm over m, it's just the risk-free rate plus market prices of risk times the systematic risks. M0 is 1, and here's larger M0. Okay, so there are two properties which we care about. Property 1 is precisely that thing here. Yeah, we want to better understand why does it hold that the expected change in the SDF is nothing else than the risk-free rate. And then property 2, yeah, we come to that in a minute. Let's do property 1 first. Okay, so by definition, the SDF was defined such that MTRT, we had that definition or characteristic 3 of what's an SDF, is just that one here. So we said that MT times RT is a martingale. That's how we defined MT, that it fulfills that relationship. Now what that just means is that the expected change in MTRT, that needs to be 0. That is what has to hold if the product MTRT is indeed a martingale. Yeah, that's a martingale property. Okay, therefore, we just do a simple Ito calculus application. Now, what is dm times RT? The expectation, we just leave it on the left, and now we have the product rule, MT dRT plus RT dmt plus DMT DRT. Okay, so that needs to be 0 for the martingale property. What we do is we divide that entire thing by MT, and let's also divide that term by RT. Now these are both positive terms, so we can just do that. Okay, which means we keep the expectation just on the left here, we divide by M and R, so what we have is DRT divided by RT plus DMT divided by MT plus the instantaneous covariation that needs to be 0. Okay, now that is 0 anyway because DRT, the relative change in the money market account, is deterministic. Now, there's no stochastic variation, so that there's no co-movement between the SDF and the risk-free rate. That part is 0. Now, that is known as of t anyway, so therefore we can put that out. The expectation of dr over r is just rt dt, and that goes to the other side. So that has to equal minus dmt divided by mt. Right, that is property 1. Therefore, property 1 is really just the result of the defining characteristic of an SDF, namely that mt times the money market account needs to be a martingale. And based on that restriction, the SDF is restricted such that its conditional growth rate is minus the risk-free rate. Now, what is property 2? Property 2 is basically the property such that for any instrument I, for any financial asset that you care about, it must hold. Keep in mind, for any I with, right, if we say that every instrument has some drift, it has some volatility process, and it's exposed to some Brownian shocks, then for any instrument I, it holds, that the risk premium of that instrument I, that needs to be equal to minus the co-movement of the return of the instrument with the SDF. Right? This is typical insight we have from so many finance theories, that the risk premium is large not because the volatility is large of an instrument, but the premium is only large if the instrument has a lot of systematic risk, where that is systematic risk, and that's the risk that the asset has, and that's the instantaneous co-movement. So if there's a lot of co-movement, then the instrument pays a high premium. If the co-movement is zero, then the instrument I pays just an expected return that equals risk-free rate. So we know what DBM, what DM over M looks like based on a definition of an SDF. We can therefore put the market price of risk out. It's a minus lambda. It goes out, and then we just have DSIT, the return of instrument I with the systematic sources of risk. Yeah, so the risk premium of an instrument is nothing else than a linear combination of the market prices of risks in the economy. And this linear combination depends on the amount of risk, the amount of systematic risk that an investment I has, then times the market price of that source of risk. Okay, so we want to derive that relationship here. Now, the way we do that is, again, by definition, we had that MT times SIT is a martingale, meaning it needs to be equal to that product. Okay, that was the characteristic four of the definition of an SDF. Now, what that means is just the conditional expected change in the product that needs to be zero. That is the martingale property. Okay, what we now do again is a little exercise in Itô calculus. So we leave the expectation on the left here, and now we just do the product rule. So what do we have? We have SIT DMT plus MT DSIT plus the co-movement between DSIT and DMT. Okay, and that by the martingale property needs to be zero. Okay, so like we did previously, we just divide. We divide by SIT, and we also divide by MT. Okay, let's just do that. So we have plus, and now that part. Okay, that needs to be zero. Okay, what do we have? That part, we already know what that looks like because of property one, that is just minus RT dt. Okay, that part in expectation is just mu IT dt. And that is the instantaneous co-movement between both instruments. So I just leave it like it is right now. I bring it to the other side. So that has to be equal, so therefore it gets a minus dSIT SIT DMT MT. Okay. We're just rewriting that thing, which just tells us that the instantaneous risk premium of an instrument needs to be equal to the instantaneous covariation between that instrument and the stochastic discount factor. Right? And what we could add in addition, if dm over m equals minus rdt minus lambda dbm, then it follows that the instantaneous risk premium in the economy of instrument I is nothing else than the vector of market prices of risk multiplied by the sources of risk that the instrument has. That was sigma it dbit, comma, and now the SDF that has been put out is just dbmt. So here again, very nicely, you see it's not just the volatility which determines the amount of risk premia, it is really the amount of co-movement that instrument I has with the systematic sources of risk, and then multiplied by the market price of risk per unit of systematic risk. Okay, that's what we wanted to show.